As a teen coming from humble beginnings, you grew up idolizing early retirement coming from immortal sports figures. And then we grow up and realize that we all have our own definitions and perspectives to the thought of not having to work to sustain ourselves. A lot of people talk about early retirement. Early retirement means that it's the end of your career, right? And for me, I'm too young to think of it as the end of a career. And that's why I'm thinking more of financial independence as a strategy for me, because financial independence is the means of you being able to create a foundation to then be able to do whatever you want to do and not having to be dependent on an employer to pay you a salary on a monthly basis, yearly basis, to be able to sustain and pay your bills. So my focus this last 5 years was to get to financial independence and not necessarily early retirement, because I'm just getting started. So now one of the properties that we're working on is a fire damaged property. And what we're doing in this property is we're basically gonna fix it up. It's a 3-unit property. We're gonna fix it up and then rent it out. So in that property, we have a construction loan. And the construction loan is based on draws that you do each time you get to a certain stage of construction. Right now, we just finished some of the framing, and we also finished some of the, or all of the roof. Because the fire was on the third floor, and the roof, we actually had to open it all up. And at that point, we did all the framing for that. We now have the roof all done. And now the bank is coming back and saying, we're going to go and see the work. And for this instance, the hard money lenders that we work with, they actually have online setup where they actually do things virtually. So we just do a walkthrough with the video camera and the inspectors right there. And they see the work that was completed. And that's exactly what we're going to do now. We're just going to do a walkthrough. And then after that, they're going to just wire us the money to then, you know, continue on with the renovation process. For me, it was financial independence from the beginning, because I knew that I didn't want to go back to work. I did not want to go back to work. And that was my main thing. In fact, right after I lost my job, it was a time period where, you know, we needed additional funds, and we did everything we could not to have to work for somebody else. So we started a small landscaping company around our neighborhood, and we started making money that way. And we found other ways to make money to be able to sustain ourselves in the very beginning of creating our business. Now we have enough units. We have 17 units, 7 of them we're working on right now. We're going to go through some of them today. So you guys can see it. It took a lot of work, and we had to think outside of the box to be able to get there. So for you, I say you first have to decide what you want to do and why, and then you're going to be able to find out how you're going to do it. So start there, look to see how we're doing it, and see if it fits your criteria. If it's some of the things that we're doing fits your criteria, we're going to be almost like that page. Instead of staring at a blank page where you're starting from scratch, we are starting the first paragraph. And then you could say, okay, now I have an idea of to get started. And now I'm going to edit this paragraph and continue the rest of my story. And that's what you want to do. Don't take it as, you know, a step-by-step process of how to do things. And any video you watch is not going to step-by-step process of how you do things. It's going to be a first paragraph of how to do it. And it's going to be up to you to be the editor of that rest of that story. This was a 4-unit property we purchased at $275. We put about $320 to fix this property as well. And this one needed substantial work, even though there wasn't a fire damage. It needed substantial work. And we could go again into the details in another video. But basically, we had to gut the entire place. And now we have a 4-unit. And the valuation, we could definitely sell this place at $900,000 right now. This was 2 years ago we bought the place. We could probably sell it $900,000 and maybe even push it to $950,000 just because of the finishes that we implemented. And the fact that you basically almost have a brand new home of a 4-unit home that's going to produce $7,000 to $8,000 a month. And here we're just putting the finishing touches, you know, the painting's going in, we're going to be cleaning up, and we're going to be showing the property in the next couple of days to potential tenants.
We're not like a big company. We're a couple that have a couple of units.
Yeah, so it's a balance between like getting all their information, like 4 or 5 people that are going to meet us there.
Mm-hmm.
It's a range of people that I've completely vetted. I've called all their references. I've seen all the financials that I need, so I've spoken to them. All their questions have been answered. And then others that I have just some of their information.
Okay.
and I'm going to have to do a little more vetting after, but I know that they make enough money, and I know how many people are going to live there, and I'm just running out of time to basically get all their information in before we are going to be there to show it. Mm-hmm. You know, some of the people that go through the units might say, oh, I thought the street was going to be different. Or, oh, it turns out I'm going to need a little more space. You know what mm-hmm. I mean? So they're interviewing us also. You have to have room for people to also, qualified people to then say, no, actually, I'm going to go with something else. And that has also happened. We've had some people that were qualified, and it took us too long to show it. They went to another apartment.
Yeah, yeah. So, it's definitely a balance, and hopefully we find the right guys starting tomorrow. So sometimes we want to get to do the things that we love, and that's what we want to get to early retirement. But if you're creative, there's other ways that you can do it. My brother, where we're going right now, we went to his studio, and he's actually making it happen. He's being creative in a field that's oversaturated, and he's still, you know, finding ways to make money in that field of music production. And we're going to talk to him about how is he making it. And again, this is just ideas that you guys can start looking into to be creative, to do the things that you want to do. So let's go and talk to my brother and see how he's doing it.
From music, because, you know, I have people coming in. It's not where I want it to be right now, but it does leave me off a couple bucks. So I have them give me their BMI number, do their BMI number. BMI is a company that helps you, basically gives you a number, and that's your artist number. Now you could put that on DistroKid, which is the thing that distributes your music.
Okay.
And now you could earn those copyrights. Like, this is my music, this is who I am. So it's like your original number.
Nice.
So I get that number, I put my number, we collab on DistroKid, so they get 80%, I get 15%,
mm-hmm.
And then through that, you know, if they get streams, I get money for that. The second way is recording artists. So I either do A, record, just they come in and record, or B, they come in and I record and mix and master on the spot.
Gotcha.
So, and mix and master, they usually go for the mix and master on the spot. So a mix is basically getting all the levels and all of the vocals correct. So we have to get all the vocals correct with the beat, make sure the beat's on time with the vocal, and then make sure that the levels are all on 6 dB.
Mm.
And that way, when it goes to the master, mm-hmm. the master is the frequencies. So you mess with the highs of the vocal to match with the low of the beat. So with the mix and mastering, I make $75 an hour. And I'm definitely making well over $500 every week. Leaves me with good money.
And that's just one stream.
Yeah, and that's one three, yeah.
Right, so you're basically saying, hey, you know, and I'm also making money through more passive income where, you know, I made the music once, and then after that, whatever stream out there with another artist, I'm also making money from the music. And then I think you're also selling beats online as well.
Like yesterday, an artist came in, he didn't have a beat, I sold him a beat, $100. Somebody hears from somebody else that I make beats, or they see one of my beats online and they hit me up personally and I send them a beat and they give me money for it. And with that, I make like $200-$300 a week.
Okay.
And that's, you know, that's literally just off of selling one or two beats a week.
So, and this is, again, it's just more local, mm-hmm. and you're trying to expand online, mm-hmm. now, mm-hmm. and that's going to bring it to another level, right? It's great to see how much you've grown and how you become a true entrepreneur just to be able to sustain doing what you love,
mm-hmm.
you know? And like I said, I remember you as a little kid, and mm-hmm. I was like, kid, it's going to be hard for you to make money because there's so many people out there trying to do what you're doing. Yeah. But now you're expanding it, and you're saying, you know what? Yeah, now I need to become more of an entrepreneur that's going to solve problems, mm-hmm. with what you're doing.
Yep.
And now you're starting a brand to start expanding yourself out there. Mm-hmm. And eventually, you're just going to be bringing in the moolah, baby.
Yeah. Right? That's how it is.
So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please subscribe. Please like this video. And let me know in the comments if you guys want to know anything else that we covered here today. My goal is to show you how we're achieving financial independence. We're going to show you how we do vacation hacking. We're going to show you how to do house hacking. We're going to show you different aspects it takes to get to financial freedom. And again, it's not just the numbers. It's not just the finance part. It's also the mentality part. And we're going to be going through that in these videos. And hopefully you guys join us in our journey. And we'll see you guys in the next video. Thank you.